finally, it is here! From today, we can all become film directors. Yes, text-to-video and image-to-video that is open source and free for all of us. And it can even make images of memes come alive. This is Stable Video, which has studied 600 million videos. And we have this too, and this too. Oh my! Three amazing papers! Yummy! So, what is going on here? Well, simple. You just write a piece of text, and Stable Video can generate a video for you in about 2 to 3 minutes. It compares favorably against the competition at this moment. I say at this moment because this result was recorded at a particular point in time, and these systems improve so rapidly that, for instance, Runway may be way better by the time you see this comparison. But it doesn't end here. Not even close. There is another text-to-video AI that you can kind of try right now. And there is even more. In fact, there is so much going on, I don't even know where to start. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. So, first, Stable Video. This was trained on about 600 million videos and now can generate new ones for you. It is free and open source, however, you still need some computational resources to run it. I'll put potential places that can run it for you in the video description. If you found some other place where other fellow scholars can run it for free, please leave a comment about it. Thank you. It takes approximately 2 to 3 minutes to create a video. And there is a lot to like here. Finally, an open source solution. This means that you will soon be able to run this on the phone, in your pocket, as freely as you wish. Glorious! However, it is not perfect. Not even close. Sometimes you get no real animation, but instead a camera panning around. Also, you probably already inferred that from these results, but it cannot generate longer videos, but that's not all. Its generated videos also typically showcase not too much motion. Third, you know the deal, don't expect good text outputs from it. Not yet, anyway. And fourth, it is a bit of a chunker. What does that mean? Well, you need a lot of video memory to perform this. I am hearing 40 gigabytes, although there is already a guide to get it down to under 20 or maybe even 10 gigabytes. Link is in the description. From seeing the nature of these limitations, my guess is that the memory requirements will be cut down substantially very soon. However, there are more tools coming up in the meantime. Here is Emu Video. This is incredible. Look, it is so good at generating natural phenomena and it even has a hint of creativity. Wow! Fantastic results! And the paper showcases this, which is a sight to behold. Goodness! Are you seeing what I am seeing? This is a user study where humans look at the results and whatever other technique you see this compared against, it has a win rate often in the 80% region against image and video. Here is what image and video look like, and that is definitely one of the best ones out there. And now, this new one, still better. Wow! But it gets better. Just creating high-quality results is not enough. Just consider a technique that always gives you a high-quality video, perhaps always the same, and ignores your prompts. That is a high-quality result, however, faithfulness to the prompts also needs to be measured. And on that, this new technique has no equal. Nothing is even close. Wow! And fantastic news! You can, kind of, try this technique out for free in a website right now. The link is obviously in the description, waiting for you fellow scholars. You can assemble these text prompts and see immediately what the system will do with them. I love the creativity here. Every solution is at least pretty good, in my opinion, and some of the solutions are just excellent. For instance, this one. So good! You can also look at some images here and perform image to video. These really came to life here. So good! Or search for a gallery of text to video results. I loved the robots here, but when I looked for scholarly content, nothing. We need more scholarly content. Well, maybe next time. Also, this is a great paper, so it contains a user study that is so much more detailed than this. They also look at sharpness, smoothness, amount of motion. Yes, you remember from the stable video project that this is super important, and object consistency as well. Now, not even this one is perfect. The resolution of these videos is 512 by 512. Not huge. But this is almost guaranteed to be improved just one more paper down the line. Also, this is not open source, not at the moment anyway. Now, why is it important if it is free and open source like the previous stable video? Well, have a look at this. I love this image. So, why is this interesting? Well, have a look and you see here that the best performing large language models are all proprietary. These are closed models. However, there are other language models that are nearly as good, just a step or two behind, but these are free and open source. So, this means that intelligence is not in the hands of just one company, but a nearly as good intelligence you can run yourself on your laptop and soon on your smartphone too. Just imagine if the best model out there is unwilling to help you or starts hallucinating, in that case you would have no other choice. But with open source models, this will never happen. There is always going to be a kind little robot helping you. And this is the importance of open source models. And if you think that we are done, well, fellow scholars, hold on to your papers for the third amazing paper for today, EMU Edit. This helps us edit images iteratively. The iterative part is key here. This means that we can start from an image that we like, something that we got from a text-to-image AI perhaps, and then it is rarely the case that everything comes out exactly how we envisioned. So, from now on, not a problem at all. We just add subsequent instructions and much of the image will remain, only the parts that we wish to change will be replaced. So, if you need the same EMU, the same background, but make it a fireman, there we go! And, oh my, look, finally, scholarly content! Good! And when compared to the competition, this one is also so far ahead of them. Goodness, look at that! Instruct Pix2Pix is just from a year ago, and Magic Brush is from less than 6 months ago, and both of them are outperformed significantly here. There are other cases which are a bit closer, but I still prefer the new one here. So, three amazing use cases, three amazing papers. I hope that you share my feeling that this is an incredible time to be alive. Research breakthroughs are happening every week. What a time to be alive! Subscribe and hit the bell icon if you wish to see more. If you're looking for inexpensive cloud GPUs for AI, Lambda now offers the best prices in the world for GPU cloud compute. No commitments or negotiation required. Just sign up and launch an instance. And hold on to your papers, because with the Lambda GPU Cloud, you can now get on-demand H100 instances for just $199 per hour. Yes, $199. And they are one of the first cloud providers to offer publicly available on-demand H100 access. Did I mention they also offer persistent storage? So, join researchers at organizations like Apple, MIT, and Caltech in using Lambda Cloud instances, workstations, or servers. Make sure to go to lambdalabs.com/papers to sign up for one of their amazing GPU instances today.